Style with Sanaz. We're here today just north of Toronto and we're doing a beautiful house. Fun fact, the client and I go back 20 years, so this is a very special house to me. It's fully renovated, 4 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms, over 9,000 square feet, just about $10 million. Really excited to show you what's inside. Come on inside and have a look. The design process of this house started a few weeks back when we came in for our initial consultation. I absolutely fell in love with this house because it has so many gorgeous features. One of them being that it's situated on a golf course and the beautiful view from the great room into that space when you walk in through the door is just really breathtaking. And I kind of wanted to bring that nature side into the house and kind of let everything kind of flow through together. I know it's staging, but we're not just staging, we're styling the house. So we gotta make it perfect. With the finishes, we had the walnut, we had the wrought iron, we had the black windows, and I kind of wanted to play with all of that with our furniture. So you'll notice we did a lot of neutrals, but then I have some pieces that are kind of very raw looking that will kind of just blend into the house and just make everything so perfect. Very excited to see how everything comes through. I'm excited that you guys can join us and go through this process with us. So let's see what happens. Wish me luck. So we're all finished now. It's 6 hours later. Everyone's left. I'm here to show you around, show you what we did with the house. I hope you like it. Let's go have a look. So presenting the great room, a few reasons why I love this room, the absolutely gorgeous windows. Beautiful height. This just gives so much luxury, so much space to the room. You just feel like you're kind of outdoors. And that's why we brought in all the greenery and some of the natural elements in just to kind of give you that feel. So the great room is a living room slash family room, and that's what we tried to do with our styling. We did a little bit of the formal sofa love set, but then we have the lounger chairs that we had custom made for this room. We have our coffee table here, which I actually came up with the idea to have this custom made. So we did the half moon with the circle inside, they're both vinyl. And then I thought to give it a little bit of a punch, add a little bit of black into it since we do have it going on around the house. And that's where I got my inspiration, was these windows. So the windows have the black frame, which is absolutely stunning. Just gives it such a great pop, such a great contrast against the white paneling that's framed the windows. And what I had custom made was these mirrors on top of each sideboard. So previous to us having styled this room, it was just all panels and just drywall. I had the frames measured, had the installers come in today, install them for us, and I think it absolutely turned out stunning with the, you know, large oversized flat screen TV on the fireplace. So the fireplace is floor to ceiling height, and it kind of follows through with the windows, and that's why I decided to give some height with my plants here and some of the other tall pieces that we use. So this area of the house was a little bit tricky for me because when I first walked in, it was completely empty. Between the great room and the kitchen, what do you do with an open space like this? Well, I thought the best idea was, because it does lead to the outside terrace and then downstairs into the backyard, I thought to create a little casual sitting space. What better to do that with than four accent chairs, nice round table, couple accent tables, some accessories, and you have a beautiful sitting area which complements kind of in between both rooms, creates a little bit of a balance. So this is the finished product in the kitchen. Everyone knows the kitchen is the heart of the home, and what better way to have that than have a 20-foot island in your kitchen. So we did that by dressing it up with 6 bar stools. Then we added some accents just to give a pop of color to all the neutral tones. On this side, we have a 6-seater table, 6 chairs. You could still do more in this space, but again, just not to clutter up and take up too much room. We decided to go with pretty good sized chairs and obviously your gorgeous view. Let's go have a look at the dining room now. One of my favorite dining rooms that we have styled, I have to say, is this one. It was just plain room, nothing too interesting about it. We ended up putting up 2 lights instead of the typical 1 light fixture that most people do. I suggested to my client to do 2 just to give it a little bit more length, 1 and 2, keep the room a little bit more interesting. It's a little bit hard sometimes when you don't have wallpaper and too much design going on in the room to keep the room interesting. So little touches like this really go a long way. We ended up going with 10 chairs instead of the 8. I think it fit perfectly. Then we accented with some artwork. Again, I kind of find it to be too much sometimes when you do too many pieces of art or too many pieces of mirror. So I opted to go with this look. I think it turned out great. So every house needs a good office. And I think you would agree that this one, they did a pretty good job filling in all the little holes. Did a beautiful walnut finish in the wall unit. And what I really like about this is the fact that they added some glass into the wall unit. So it kind of lightens up the space versus having everything so solid. Again, everything was wall paneled. It's all walnut. So we opted to go with a chrome desk, chrome chair, and I added a little bit of brass just because everyone knows I do love brass. And also just to give it a little bit more of depth. Instead of just doing everything one finish, add a little bit of pop to your room. It goes a long way. So a part of my job other than the staging, is to assist my clients to make each space look to its full potential. One of the things here that I kind of helped my client with was the light fixture in the foyer. The thing is that when the space is so big, when you put a light fixture and you have to make sure the size is proportionate to the space that you're working with. And for here, I felt that having one light fixture will not do the job. So what did we do? We went with one light fixture with 3 pendant lights hanging from it. And check it out behind me. It's absolutely stunning. It's all crystals, about 3 foot each, just elevated in height, and it just gives so much drama, makes the space look that much more better. He did the wrought iron railings, which I thought was really nice too. Black on walnut, again, absolutely stunning, nice and warm. Let's go have a look upstairs, see what's going on. This is another area that I found a little bit challenging. Again, to do one light fixture in this whole space here, it would get lost. It's better not to even put anything and just do it with pot lights. But what I thought was to create a little bit of a dramatic feel is to do 3 lights, each one on a different level. This is what it came up with. I think it turned out very nice. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in to episode 3 of Style with Sanaz. We had a great time staging this house, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment on our page. And we hope to catch you on episode 4. See you next time.